capital of the International English Toronto.
Welcome.
Again. So today, this was our schedule for today. You've already done the welcome and icebreaker. You've finished your placement test. And right now, we're doing the general orientation with social activities and tour. Okay? So you're going to do a little bit of an orientation where you learn information now. And then we're going to take you to have some lunch. After lunch, you'll come back here for the academic orientation and a tour of Toronto. First of all, please remember the Kaplan Wi-Fi password. So the network is Kaplan, and the password is 12345678910. Very difficult, please don't forget. Okay? Actually, every day someone asks me for the password, every single day. It's great. And again, I'll just remind you about the team. You met them this morning. So this is Eris Brake, she's our director. So you can talk to her anytime. You'll see her in her office today. Terry and Safa you met today. And Lisa you see every day at the front desk. So she's always here. Then again, you met all these people this morning, so I won't go over it again, except Aliana. Aliana is our homestay manager. So if you have a homestay question, you can ask Aliana. So who here does Kaplan Homestay Program? Who's Kaplan? Oh, only three? Oh, perfect. You can talk to Elliot. Okay. And then there's me, the Student Services Manager. Very important question. You can win a prize if you get it correctly. Okay. Which country do you think I'm from? Listen carefully to my accent. Which country do you think I'm from? If you know, raise your hand. If you're right, you win this beautiful umbrella. Anyone want to guess? Wait, oh, sorry, raise your hand. We'll see. Who said England? No, sorry. No one wants to guess? In the back?
Canada.
Yes, Canada! Congratulations! Yes, Canada!
I have, yes, there you go. Congratulations.
Yes, Canada! Why is this? I don't know. I have no idea. No. Canada. God. All right. First of all, today you might have many questions, and maybe your English is low. Right? At Kaplan, we have student ambassadors. These are volunteer students who have high English level who can help with translation. So maybe you are a Brazilian student and you want to explain something in Portuguese. Our Brazilian ambassador can help with that. Also, our ambassadors have been here for a long time, so they can help you with the city, with information about Kaplan, or with just fun things to do on the weekend. Okay? So outside, we have the ambassador board, so you can see all of our ambassadors. Right? And we'll show it to you later. Next, rule one. Can you guess rule one of Kaplan? Yeah, fantastic, nice. English only, yes, English only. Okay. Please speak only English. If we hear you speak your language, we will say English only. If you always speak your own language and not English, we will give you a warning letter. Okay. So only English, right? Also, how many people came to Canada with a friend from your country? Who came with a friend from your country? Perfect, perfect. I'm sorry, you can't talk to each other anymore. Yes. Only English. Yes, I'm sorry, you're separated. Good luck, have a nice vacation. No, only English, okay? If we hear you speak English a lot, we will give a green card. The green card, on Friday, we pick one, and the winner gets a prize. So the more you speak English, the more green cards you get, the better your chance to win a prize. Okay? So English, and English. Nice. Next, very important information for new students adapting to life. Number one is tipping culture. Who knows what tipping is? Who knows tipping? Yeah? It's horrible. And tax. So in Canada, we always add the tax to the price. So if you go shopping and you see a shirt, and the shirt is $10, and you have $10, do you have enough money?
No.
No, I'm sorry. Welcome to Canada. No. You need $11.30. Okay? So we always add 13% tip. Always, always, always. Okay? Next, in Canada, waiting in line is very important. I know in some countries, people don't wait in line so much. I've been to those countries. But in Canada, we love to wait in line. Even if there's nothing there, we wait. So be ready. Canadians love to wait in line. Don't forget, Canadians always smile, and we always say sorry. Okay? You'll be very annoyed after 1 week. Even if I hit this, oh, sorry, sorry. Okay, so be ready. And finally, how to tip. So when you wonder how to tip, in a restaurant, we usually tip 15% of the bill. Okay? If everything is good, 15%. If it's bad, maybe 5%. Okay? Yeah. If you don't tip, they will probably tip in your drink. No. But you should always tip. At a bar, it's 50 cents or $1 for each drink. So if you buy a beer, you tip 50 cents. If you buy a nice cocktail, probably $1. But $1 maximum. Okay? And for a taxi, it's $2 or $3. So if it's a long taxi ride or a short taxi ride, it doesn't matter. It's always $2 or $3. And if you don't want to tip for taxi, you can also take Uber. Okay? In Toronto, we have Uber. If you don't know how to use Uber, come see me and I can show you. It's very nice to see. Next, public transit. So in Toronto, we have the TTC, and the TTC means subway, bus, and streetcar. Okay? The subway goes from 6 a.m. until 1 a.m., or on Sunday, it will start at 9 a.m. Okay? This is the subway line, and if you want, you can ask Mel or me. We have this map. You can take a picture of it. Better picture. So after 1 a.m., there is a bus that follows the subway line 24 hours. So if you miss the subway, it's okay. You can take a bus. Okay. Some buses are 24 hours, and some streetcars are 24 hours too. You just need to check the schedule on the bus or streetcar. And also, for public transit, you can buy a weekly pass or a monthly pass. For you guys, your best deal is the weekly pass, if you buy it today. Okay? Then you have unlimited rides for 1 week. You can use it as much as you want. Okay? If you don't want to buy a pass, TTC tokens are $3 each, okay? Or if you want to pay cash, it's $3.25 cash. But remember, there's no change. So if you give $4, they keep the $4. They don't give change on the TTC. Okay? So your best bet is weekly pass or buy tokens. And finally, Kaplan Student Health and Safety. So just about the safety in Toronto. If you have an emergency, you call 911. 911 is for police, fire, or ambulance. Please do not call Kaplan for emergency. Call 911. It happened. So they say, Jim, someone stole my money. Okay. Call 911. So if, but don't worry, Toronto is very safe. I'm sure you will not need 911. Okay? And only for emergency. Only emergency. Don't call, excuse me, I lost my cell phone. No. Okay. Only an emergency. Right? If you are sick or you need some medical help, you can talk to me or Mel or Sam or Danielle. We will find you a doctor. Okay? Also, I have first aid training and Danielle has first aid training. So we know what to do to help. Okay? Mel, do you have first aid?
No.
Mel does not, but that's okay. She can still call a doctor. Or 911, we're okay. All right. Next. These are the rules for alcohol and drugs in Toronto. Okay? Number one, in Toronto, you must be 19 or older to drink alcohol. Okay? Or to buy alcohol. And also, if you give alcohol to someone under 19, that's illegal. So don't do it. Okay? You cannot drink outside in Toronto unless it's a park. Only in the park you can drink beer outside. Okay? You may not come to school well intoxicated. This means you cannot drink alcohol and come to class. Okay? Do not drink alcohol before school. If you are intoxicated, we will ask you to leave, or you could be dismissed from school. That means we will say no more caffeine. Okay? You all look like very smart people. I'm sure you will not do this. Also, please remember, in Canada, it's illegal to smoke or buy marijuana. Sometimes you will smell it in Toronto, but it's illegal. Please keep in mind. And if you have a car, you cannot drink and drive. Even one beer. If you have one drink and drive, it's illegal. So remember, in case you rent a car. In some countries, you can have a little alcohol and drive, but not in Ontario. So please remember. And for smoking, this one is the most important for you guys too. In Canada, you must be 19 or older if you want to smoke or buy cigarettes. And most important, you must be 9 meters away from a door or window. So imagine I'm smoking. My cigarette. You. And this is a door. I must go 9 meters away.
I'm going to go over here.
Now I'm okay. If the police see you smoking beside a door, it's a $300 ticket. Okay. So don't smoke near a door or a window. Okay. You must use smoking areas. And again, remember, smoking marijuana is illegal in Canada. Okay? Please remember. And safety tips. Toronto is a very, 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 very safe city, but always remember some things. Avoid walking alone at night. So if you are leaving a party, make sure you leave with a friend. Don't walk by yourself. Okay? And in Toronto, it's very good. The night bus, so the bus at night, will stop anywhere. Okay? So if you live far from a bus stop, you can ask the bus driver, please stop here, near my house. And the bus driver will stop closer to your house. Okay? They will not drive to your house, but close to your house. So remember that. Use the buddy system. So especially in your first week, it's important you have a friend who knows where you are going. So you go to the nightclub together, your friend and you check on each other. Like, okay, I'm leaving now, I will call you when I'm home. It's called the buddy system. And also, remember in Toronto, when you go out, you go to the bar, you're with your friends, you're having fun. I have my drink, I'm drinking. Do not put your drink and walk away. Do not do that. Just in case, someone might put something inside. So always watch your drink or hold your drink or give it to a friend. That's why the buddy system is important. And if it's late, if you can, take a taxi or Uber. Uber is very cheap, so it's always a good idea if you can't take the bus. Okay? So please remember. Again, Toronto is one of the safest cities in the world, so you should be okay, but just to be safe. And emergency evacuation. So right here on the wall is a fire alarm. So see the red thing that says fire? Okay. That's not to start a fire, it's a fire alarm. If you hear this, follow your teacher. Okay. You always follow your teacher. If you are here in the student lounge and you can't follow your teacher, go to the exit. There's a fire exit right here, and meet us in the dog park. Today, when you do the tour of Toronto with Mel or Sam, they will show you the dog park. We meet beside the fountain if there's a fire alarm. Please do not take your bag, leave everything, and go. If you hear the alarm, just go. Some people, they hear the alarm, like, oh, fire, where? So, don't run, go walk. So if fire evacuation safety, remember, just follow your teacher. Relax, be calm. The whole building is concrete, so you'll be okay, but we still need to leave. And finally, if you see something, say something. So if you see something strange, come and tell the captain staff. So maybe outside you see something that looks strange, come and tell me right away. Okay? It'll be fine. Right? And for medical insurance, if you don't have medical insurance, please see Danielle as soon as possible. In Canada, the hospital is very expensive if you don't have insurance. Just to go inside is about $200. So if you don't have medical insurance, make sure you have medical insurance. Okay. We can also tell you where you can see a doctor easily. So where you can see a doctor easily. All right, do you have any questions about the health and safety? Yeah. Okay, anything, yeah.
Okay, what happens